Tucson Mayor Jonathan Rothschild and Phoenix Mayor Greg Stanton led a trade mission of business and city leaders to Mexico as part of an ongoing effort to foster relations with Arizona's largest trading partner. The delegation traveled to Hermosillo and Mexico City and met with national officials and business representatives. Joining me tonight to talk about the trip is Phoenix City Manager David Cavazos and Phoenix City Councilman Michael Nowakowski. Also here is Glenn Hammer, President and CEO of the Arizona Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and Barry Broom, Greater Phoenix Economic Council President and CEO. Gentlemen, thanks for joining us on Horizonte. David, in the introduction, we talked about this ongoing effort. So this is the second trip that the mayor's made. Tell us a little bit about the genesis of it and what the intent of the trip was.
Good evening, Jose. Thank you so much for inviting us on your show. Mexico is our largest trading partner. It's so important for us to build upon our relationship that we've had for so many years. We visited Hermosillo, our sister city, for 36 years, our first sister city, and we went to Mexico City, and we focused on investment, trade, and tourism.
And Councilman, another aspect of the trip, something else you focused on, was dispelling rumors, and not just rumors or perceptions about Arizona, but also perceptions about Mexico and security and stuff. Tell us about that aspect of the trip.
You know, what was amazing is that we had the two top mayors of the city of Phoenix and Tucson, of Arizona there, and they were asking us questions about, why are you here? Well, we're here to invite you to our cities. And all the stuff that they see on the news and reading the newspapers are negative. And when we went down there, we were talking about how we want to create partnerships, how we want to build that bridge between Mexico and Phoenix, Mexico and Tucson. And they were amazed. They were amazed that we were there. They were asking us some hard questions. Is it true that if you happen to be brown skinned, would they pull you over and stop you? He said, no. Matter of fact, our new police chief happens to be Chief Garcia, Mexican descent, that we actually have two council members, myself and Danny Valenzuela, that happens to be of Mexican descent also.
So while you're there, the governor issues her executive order in connection with the deferred action program, basically saying those students, even if they get, or those kids, even if they get deferred action, aren't going to be able to get Arizona driver's licenses. A lot of controversy in Arizona. What was the reaction there?
Well, it was actually the first day that we were there in Hermosillo, and we met with the governor, and we just finished meeting with the mayor, and they had us on the front page of the Hermosillo paper. And right there, big front and center, is the delegation inviting people, telling people how safe Phoenix is, and welcome to Phoenix. And all of a sudden, you have a little blurb about the whole incident with the governor and denying our students, our children, driver's license and all that. So it kind of put us in an awkward position, but at the same time, it was great that we were there. We were there to tell the true story.
Now, on the flip side, American businesses and travelers are concerned about security in Mexico, and I understand the Mexicans talk to you all about that.
You know what? They actually have a campaign, and the campaign is called Mexico, the Place That You Thought You Knew. And it's amazing. The U.S. Ambassador actually has a website that you can, if you're going to be traveling in Mexico, you can type in the state or the city that you're going to be in, and they'll tell you how the traffic is and also if there's crime and how safe it is. And the U.S. Ambassador is telling us it's amazing how safe Mexico is. We were asking questions about walking in Mexico City, if we should be careful. And he says, you know, just like any major city, there's those bad areas and there's those good areas. But you don't have to be afraid of walking in downtown, that every area is secure, and that if you'd like to, you can look on the website and you can actually find out what cities are safe and what cities they have some concerns about.
Barry, Glenn, we tout the fact that Mexico's Arizona's largest trading partner, but that's been true for decades. Why the interest now in enhancing this relationship?
Well, it's becoming even more important. Mexico right now appears to be the fastest growing economy in Latin America. They're clocking at about a 4% clip. I mean, one of the things that I think is very important for the viewers is, you know, a lot of people will ask safety questions and things like that. Mexico is, you could really feel the growth. There's a migration to higher end manufacturing. There's a lot of Mexican citizens that love to come to Arizona and enjoy our wonderful cities. And for a state like Arizona, where we have a lot going on in manufacturing, where tourism supports about 200,000 jobs, deepening the relationship with Mexico is just simply vital for Arizona's economic prosperity.
And Barry, what are the opportunities for Mexican businesses in Arizona, particularly the greater Phoenix area?
Well, I think there's a couple of things. I mean, one of the things that Glenn talked about is the manufacturing sector in Mexico is becoming high tech. And one of the conversations that we had here in the Valley, we have almost 800 aerospace and defense companies. And one of the industries that's really starting to morph and be impressive in Mexico is aerospace and defense. How do you get your technology services and your R&D services to the Mexican cluster? Now, you can get that out of Greater Phoenix. And it also creates an opportunity for a city like Tucson. I talked quite a bit with Mayor Rothschild about working with TRIO on a nearshoring strategy just outside of Tucson along the Mexican border. So this high-tech manufacturing sector is very interesting in aerospace and defense. They could interface with Arizona, one of the top five aerospace markets in the United States, right now and get R&D engineering services. It's the same type of services that the Greater Phoenix region's supplying California and Texas, we could supply Mexico. I think the other thing that that Glenn talked about that's really interesting is the pace at which Mexico is growing, its sophistication. It's growing faster than Brazil now. So if you talk to most people on the economic side, they'll consider Brazil, Argentina. Argentina's had some unique problems, but as really up-and-coming, impressive economies. Mexico is trending to be the fifth biggest economy in the world. That's impressive when you consider China, the United States, and India are going to be the top three. Mexico's trending to pass either Japan or Germany as an economy in the next 10 to 20 years. That's unheard of in global economic history. So there's a lot more of a knowledge, technical interface that can occur here now than there has been in the last 100 years.
And you focused on exports, basically, from Arizona businesses to Mexico. What about Mexican investment?
Well, I think, you know, one of the things we found out, we met a lot of prominent families in Mexico City, and they already have homes in the Phoenix region. I mean, some of the most impressive, high net worth, innovative, entrepreneurial families in Mexico are already here very quietly. You know, they have homes here because they enjoy living here. I think there's a tremendous amount of opportunity for Mexico to deliver goods and services into this market. I think there's obviously a very impressive consumer brand and position with our Latino community in Greater Phoenix and in Arizona. One of the things we talked to, amazing what people don't know about you, but having leaders in Mexico City learn that, you know, we're a 40% Latino state is information that's new to them. I think one of the things that was very important was communicating that, you know, we're a state of Latinos and Anglos, not just Anglos. And it's a very eclectic and integrating culture that more and more is going to be more like the future of America. And you know, Arizona is a state that has a lot of proud achievements for Latinos, not just David Cavazos, but first state university president, first congressman, first federal judge, first governor in the United States of America, Latinos all coming out of Arizona. So I think reconnecting, sort of like Councilman Nowakowski was saying, you know, the reconnection to just how important this relationship is and having a conversation about it was important. Having the mayor of Phoenix and Tucson there was important as well. And I think the trip established and reestablished, you know, the lineage between these two markets.
David, Glenn talked about tourism. And I know that's an important thing for Arizona, and you did something specifically related to that. Tell us about that.
It's extremely important. It's a $2.3 billion spend from Mexican visitors to Arizona, about 20 million people a year. But just in Sky Harbor alone, about 1 million people a year go through Sky Harbor to visit Mexico. Air service is very important. It's actually doubled over the last 5 years. And we had a visit with Volaris, which is kind of the Southwest Airlines of Mexico. New up-and-coming airlines. We have U.S. Airways. We have Aeromexico, which just expanded service from Hermosillo 40%, about $16 million economic impact. And so we're working very hard to attract Volaris Airlines to Phoenix, Arizona.
And what are the prospects for success in
that
area?
Well, really good. They got about 41 flights right now. They announced service to Denver the day we were there. They have new service to L.A. We think we got a great market. Barry mentioned 40% Latino. It's an ethnic market they're focused on, but they're going to compete with not just other airlines, but with the bus routes. They got lots of folks that are coming from Culiacan and Sinaloa and Chihuahua and León, and they think they can really generate some traffic. So we're going to work really hard to attract.
Will the buses be able to cross the border?
Well, right now the buses are crossing the border, but the price of a bus...
Well, we're talking about the luxury liners that they have.
The luxury liners, the price of a bus right now for those individuals that use buses is almost the same price as the airlines. So we really, like Southwest Airlines did early on, get people off of buses onto planes. We want to do that with the Mexican traveler to Arizona.
Mr. Vice Mayor, as I understand it, there was an invitation that was issued to the, at least the mayors, to come back to Mexico City. Tell us about that.
You know, we actually sat down with some of the transition team, and they actually invited us to come back to the Tucson Pinos, which happens to be the White House in Mexico, back in March, this coming March. They were saying that it's very important to have this relationship with Arizona and Mexico, and that they value the two mayors coming down. Even though with all the controversy that's happening with the state of Arizona, they just admire us coming down and trying to build that partnership. But Jose, what was so important about it is that the delegation that we took, you know, Glenn was there representing the state of Arizona chamber. We had GPEC with Barry, but we also had Gonzalo from the Hispanic chamber. We also had Steve Moore from the greater, and Todd Sanders. So we had the top CEOs and presidents of all the different chambers here in the state of Arizona meeting with the top officials, top business people there. We were there to do business. We were there to actually sit down and talk about how can we build this relationship? How can we both benefit? How can you have warehouses and corporate offices here in Phoenix and Tucson, and how can we help Mexico out also?
Now, you were meeting, when you're talking about government officials, these would be members of the Calderon administration?
Correct.
What about the incoming administration?
No, basically, that was also the incoming administration that we had a special meeting with some of their transitional team, and they're the ones that actually invited us down.
Glenn, did you take some of the members of your chamber with you?
No. It was really just leaders of the different business groups.
But what do you think they're most interested in, though, your membership?
Well, there's certainly a very strong interest in increasing some of the things that David was talking about in terms of air travel, certainly tourism opportunities given the importance. The manufacturing side, I mean, Jose, the last few years we've put a lot of time working together at the state legislature to make Arizona world-class when it comes to hosting export-oriented industries. So these types of trips to have, you know, the mayors of our two largest cities doing such a great job representing our state, we felt would help stimulate increased trade and commerce.
Barry, what about your membership, which is a combination of cities and major businesses? What do you think the primary interest is in there, and what have you told them about your trip?
Well, I think there's a couple of things. One, you know, we just want to make sure that from a business standpoint, Mexico is not underestimated or underappreciated from a business perspective. And, you know, both Arizona and Mexico have had different political challenges. And even though those political challenges have occurred, as David Cavazos was saying, business is very good between Arizona and Mexico. And the business relationships transcend the politics. And the opportunity to do more together is there if we reconvene. And I wanted to just particularly, you know, reiterate the potential of nearshoring outside of Tucson. Mayor Rothschild, I was very impressed with the mayor of Tucson. Mexico doesn't compete with the United States for jobs. Mexico competes with China and India for jobs and gives North America and Arizona a concentrated employment base that we can capture and leverage benefits from that we can't out of China and India. And the ability to build industrial corridors and transportation and infrastructure between Arizona and Mexico will produce an incredible amount of jobs and wealth and tax income to the state of Arizona. So not only do we have this very good relationship, but we have the chance to make it much better.
Now Barry, how do we compete with Texas, for example, which has spent a lot of money in investment in their ports, mm-hmm. making it easier for Mexican products to get into the United States and vice versa?
Well, I mean, I think some of the things we have to do, I hate to say we continue to learn from Texas, but, you know, we need to do some of the things that Texas has done. I think the real differentiating point between Arizona and Texas is the port of entry into Southern California and the state of California. So Arizona offers two things, I think, along the border that Texas cannot offer. first thing we offer is Tucson. You know, Tucson is a highly innovative economy built around the University of Arizona. There is no Texas border community. Austin's not on the border. So there is no Texas border community that offers an innovation platform like Tucson does. That's a big opportunity. And the ingress and egress from Mexico into California is much better. We've also talked about water ports from time to time that would actually give a ingress and egress through Mexico and Arizona to China. I think one of the conversations we have, we didn't get deep enough into it, but you know, Greater Phoenix has been doing a great job and Arizona's been doing a great job of opening relationships up with China. I really do think that Mexico can interface with China in the Greater Phoenix market. So the entry point to Tucson from an innovation standpoint, the migration into the California market, and the interface with California, or interface with China, are potential advantages we can exploit. But some of the things we have to do is, you know, the absolute block and tackle bricks and mortars. I mean, there were dozens and dozens of offices by Texas communities in Mexico.
So something we might do eventually is have one of those.
Yes.
On that note, we're going to have to end the interview. We're out of time. But thank you all so much for joining us on Horizonte. Appreciate it.